set of TV gitu nih. Audio TV, radio.
Itu banyak orang.
Speaker for the house.
Santi.
Halo.
Selamat datang.
Thank you.
Ya. Ibu Mita. Ya.
Betul. Ini Bapak
Jepang.
Saudara-saudara, ada yang ketinggalan telepon di WC. Di WC perempuan ada yang ketinggalan telepon.
Suka teleponan di WC.
Siapa meninggalkan telepon di WC?
Ladies.
Ditoto.
Ntar juga yang ketinggalan ya, Arif. Karena belum ingat ntar yang ketinggalan ya, Arif.
Oh, yang punya.
Itu yang ketinggalan nyari itu.
Abis itu.
Ini lucu, aku kira telur asin.
Oke, saudara-saudara, kita akan segera memulai. Mari kita membuka firman Tuhan yang diambil dari kitab Yosua. Kita membuka kitab Yosua. Pasal 1 ayat 6 hingga ayat 9. Joshua chapter 1 verse 6 to verse 9. The book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 6 to verse 9. Saya akan bacakan buat saudara. I will read this for you. Kuatkan dan teguhkanlah hatimu, sebab engkaulah yang akan memimpin bangsa ini memiliki negeri yang kujanjikan dengan bersumpah kepada nenek moyang mereka untuk diberikan kepada mereka. Hanya kuatkan dan teguhkanlah hatimu dengan sungguh-sungguh, bertindaklah hati-hati sesuai dengan seluruh hukum yang telah diperintahkan kepadamu oleh hambaku Musa. Janganlah menyimpang ke kanan atau ke kiri, supaya engkau beruntung kemanapun engkau pergi. Janganlah engkau lupa memperkatakan kitab Taurat ini, tapi renungkanlah itu siang dan malam, supaya engkau bertindak hati-hati sesuai dengan segala yang tertulis di dalamnya. Sebab dengan demikian perjalananmu akan berhasil dan engkau akan beruntung. Bukankah telah kuperintahkan kepadamu, kuatkan dan teguhkanlah hatimu, janganlah kecut dan tawar hati, sebab Tuhan Allahmu menyertai engkau kemanapun engkau pergi. Mari kita masuk dalam doa, let us pray. Bapa dalam surga, kami sudah membaca firman-Mu, sekarang kami memohon, jelaskanlah supaya kami mengerti. Heavenly Father, we have read your word, now we pray, please explain this to us so we will understand it. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus kami berdoa, in the name of Jesus we all pray, amen. Halaman ketiga di selebaran yang ada di tangan saudara, page 3 in the hands up that you have. Tiga kali Tuhan berkata kepada Yosua, kuatkan dan teguhkanlah hatimu. So three times the Lord God says to Joshua, be strong. Yeah, be strong and be strong. Dua kali, satu di awal dan satu di akhir pesannya kepada Yosua, Tuhan mengutarakan janjinya bahwa ia akan menyertai Yosua. Betul, tambahkan kata menyertai. Twice, one in the beginning, another one at the end of his message to Joshua, the Lord God reiterates his promise that he will be with Joshua. Dan satu kali Tuhan mengingatkan Yosua untuk tidak gentar dan kecut hati. And once the Lord God tells Joshua not to be afraid or be dismayed. Nah, pertanyaannya adalah, apakah kesimpulan kita membaca semua itu? Now the question is, what is our conclusion reading all of this? Tidak lain, tidak bukan bahwa Yosua gentar atau takut, boleh. Dan kecut hati. Well, the answer is none other than Joshua is afraid and dismayed. Tuhan tahu itu sebab ia datang untuk menghibur dan menguatkan hatinya. Tambahkan kata menguatkan hatinya. God knows that. That is why he comes to comfort and to encourage Joshua. Sambung, let's continue. Sama seperti Yosua, kita pun takut. Tambahkan kata takut. Sewaktu menghadapi sesuatu yang mengerikan. Just like Joshua, we too are afraid when we have to face something terrifying, scary. Di saat gundah dan gentar, biasanya kita tidak dapat berpikir jernih dan merasa tidak berdaya. Tambahkan kata berdaya. Usually when our hearts are anxious, yeah, full of fear, we cannot think clearly anymore. And we feel helpless. Jika memungkinkan kita ingin
lari.
Betul, lari. Ya, tambahkan kata lari dan menghindar. If possible, we just want to run and avoid. Kita tidak mau menghadapi situasi yang mengerikan itu. We just don't want to face that horrifying situation. Bila pada akhirnya kita sadar bahwa kita tidak dapat menghindar, kita pun jatuh lemas dan putus asa. When in the end we realize that we cannot get away from it, what usually happens is we become like so weak, we have no more energy, and we get despaired. Di saat seperti itulah Tuhan datang, tambahkan kata datang, untuk menghibur dan menguatkan kita. In times like these, God comes to comfort and to encourage us. Saudara, kita ini mesti menyadari bahwa sebagai manusia kita terbatas. We must realize that as normal human beings, we have limitations. Kita bisa takut. We can be afraid. Ya. Nah, jadi saudara, Tuhan tahu kondisi kita. But this is what comforts us. God knows our condition. Sewaktu kita takut, Dia tahu. When we are afraid, He knows. Saya masih ingat sebelum saya operasi, saya itu biasa kan berenang di YMCA. Nah, di situ ada tulisan di dindingnya yang diambil dari Yosua pasal 1 ayat 9. Before my prostate surgery, I remember I went to the YMCA to swim, and I saw this writing on the wall taken from Joshua chapter 1 verse 9. Ya, kata-katanya adalah janganlah takut, janganlah susah hatimu, Aku akan beserta denganmu kemanapun kau pergi. Ya, the word says, do not be afraid, do not be dismayed, because I will be with you wherever you go. Nah, saudara, berkali-kali saya melewati koridor itu dan membaca tulisan itu, tapi tidak pernah kata-kata itu sepertinya tuh menangkap saya dan membuat saya membacanya, mendengarkannya, dan menerima janji Tuhan itu. Ya, yeah. Emergency. Jadi kadang-kadang telepon kita berbunyi ini. Ya, yeah, there's an emergency, so sometimes it rings. Saudara, as I said, I passed that corridor, I saw that writing on the wall many times, but never before had that actually like captured my attention and my heart to make me listen to it, to make me really receive God's promise to me. Dan firman Tuhan itulah yang saya bawa suatu saya masuk ke dalam rumah sakit. And that's the verse, the verse of the Bible that I took with me when I went to the hospital. Itu adalah pada masa COVID ya. Jadi Santi tidak bisa masuk, saya hanya di drop, saya masuk sendirian, jadi harus tunggu, harus apa, di koridor, sendirian semuanya. Jadi betapa sepinya ya sendirian. At the time it was a COVID time, so I went to the hospital by myself. Santi could not even get in there. She came later on after my surgery. But then, yeah, throughout the whole time, I had to be by myself. And it was terrifying to me. Just to be alone, yeah, not having anybody that you can talk to, but then you feel so helpless. You are in the hands of all these doctors and nurses, and you don't know the outcome. So it is unsettling, to say the least. But that verse from Joshua chapter 1 verse 9 spoke with me and gave me strength. Be not afraid, be not dismayed, for I am with you wherever you go. The word wherever really spoke to me. Kata kemanapun kamu pergi benar-benar menguatkan saya. Kemana artinya ke dalam kamar operasi juga Dia bersama kita. Ya, yeah, wherever you go, including going into the operating room, He is going to be with us. Mari kita sambung. Ada beberapa pelajaran tentang ketakutan yang dapat kita petik dari ayat-ayat ini. So there are a few lessons about fear that we can glean from this passage. Pertama, kemarin, tambahkan kata kemarin, kita kuat. Hari ini belum tentu. Yesterday we were strong, today we may not be strong. That's the fact. Kenyataan bahwa Tuhan beserta kita di hari yang lampau, belum tentu itu memperkokoh iman kita menghadapi tantangan di hari ini. Tambahkan kata hari ini. The fact that God was with us in the past or yesterday may not foster, strengthen our faith that today we will have that strength and the faith to face whatever comes today. Not necessarily. Jauh lebih mudah berkata bahwa karena kemarin kita kuat, maka besok kita akan lebih kuat. It is far easier to say because yesterday we were strong, then tomorrow we will be strong too. Easier to say that. Nah, ini yang kita mau belajar. Ujian iman bukanlah ujian di hari esok. Tambahkan kata esok. Yang jauh di mata. Ujian iman adalah ujian di hari ini. Tambahkan kata hari ini. Yang di depan mata. The test of faith is not the test of tomorrow. Something that will happen in the future that we cannot even see it now. The test of faith is today's test. What happens today? Artinya begini, saudara. Bukankah kita sering berkata, oh, saya pernah mengalami ini, itu, Tuhan beserta kita, Tuhan menolong, dan sebagainya. Maka, wah, pokoknya lain kali, wah, saya akan berani, saya akan kuat. Isn't it? Something that we usually say, oh, yesterday, or in the past, God did this for me. God this, God helped me. So I know in the future, tomorrow, I'll be strong. No matter what happens, you know, whatever happens, I will be able to face it. Because of the fact I saw how God helped me. Tomorrow. No, that's not the test of faith. The test of faith is when you are facing it right before you, in front of your eyes today. Ujian iman adalah waktu kita menghadapi apa yang kita harus hadapi itu hari ini, sekarang. Berani gak? So easier to say kita akan berani besok daripada waktu kita menghadapinya. Berani gak? You see, it is far easier to say I will be brave someday in the future. No, the test is what it is in front of your eyes. Are you brave? Do you have the courage? Karena memang enggak sama ya. Sambung, Yosua bukanlah seorang penakut, ia seorang yang berani. Tambahkan kata berani. Joshua is not a fearful man. He's not a coward, he's a brave man. Sewaktu mengintai tanah Kanaan dan berjumpa dengan penduduk Kanaan yang bertubuh besar, dia tidak takut. When he was sent as a spy along with the other 9 spies and then saw the native of the Canaanites, some of them were really big, he wasn't afraid. Ia dan Caleb justru menyemangati saudara-saudara sebangsanya. Caleb and he, in fact, encouraged his brethren not to be afraid, but to go in, take over the land. Yeah, tapi we know the story. They were afraid, so they did not want to go in. Kita tahu ceritanya, teman-temannya takut, nggak mau masuk. Joshua juga bukan orang yang tidak beriman. Betul, tambahkan kata beriman. And Joshua is not a man without faith either. He is a man of faith. So he's a man of courage and he's a man of faith. Suatu menyemangati saudara-saudara sebangsanya, ia menyandarkan imannya pada Tuhan. When he was encouraging his brethren, he encouraged them to have faith in God. Dia berkata, yang melindungi mereka sudah meninggalkan mereka. Sedangkan Tuhan menyertai kita, janganlah takut kepada mereka. He said to them, those or he or she who protected them is gone. But the Lord God, he is with us. So don't be afraid of them. So see, he's a man of faith. Yosua berani dan beriman. Itu sebab Musa memilihnya untuk menjadi panglimanya. So you see, Joshua is a man of faith and a man of courage. No wonder Moses chose him to be his general. Namun sekarang ia takut, tiba giliran Tuhan betul menyemangatinya. But now he's afraid. And now it's God's turn to encourage him. Jadi inilah pelajaran kedua yang dapat kita timba, yaitu, so here's the second lesson that we can glean. Hari ini kita dapat menolong orang. Tambahkan kata menolong. Besok belum tentu. Today we can help people. Give a hand to them, encourage them. Tomorrow, we may not be able to do so. Hari ini kita menopang orang, mungkin besok kita perlu ditopang orang, betul. Tambahkan kata ditopang. So today, we sustain, hold somebody up. Tomorrow, we may be the one who need upholding, sustaining. From somebody else. Tuhan tahu kondisi dan kebutuhan kita. Itu sebab bukan saja ia akan menyemangati kita, kadang ia pun mengirim, tambahkan kata mengirim, orang untuk memberi kita kekuatan. God knows our condition and our needs. Therefore, not only will he encourage us, at times he will also send somebody to lend a hand, to give us strength, to encourage us. Lewat mereka Tuhan berbisik, aku besertamu kemanapun, tambahkan kata kemanapun, kamu pergi dan tidak akan meninggalkanmu. So through them, through those God will send on our way. He will whisper to us, I am with you wherever you go, and I will never forsake you. Waktu salah satu anak kami masih kecil, kadang kalau lagi panas, demam, dia kejang-kejang. When our children were small, one of them every time, she had a fever, high fever, she would have a seizure. Nah, jadi saudara, pertama kali itu terjadi, kami kaget, belum tahu apa yang mesti kami perbuat, jadi kami panggil 911. Yeah, the first time it happened because we had no clue what was going on, so we call 911. Nah, saya masih ingat sekali, saya masuk ke dalam ambulans bersama dengan dia, membawanya ke rumah sakit, Santi juga ikut. Yeah, I remember I was in the ambulance with her, yeah, because she was having the seizure, and I was so distraught, I was so worried. Yeah, saya sangat takut, sangat khawatir. Nah, akhirnya sampai di rumah sakit, the moment we arrived at the hospital, the nurses just took her away from my arms. Begitu tiba, perawat-perawat langsung datang, ambil dia dari pelukan saya. Dan I remember, she cried like crazy. Because she was afraid, yeah. She did not know what was going on. Suddenly, she was snatched from us, her parents. Nah, saudara, kami tunggu di luar. Saya masih ingat sekali, saya dan Santi tunggu di ruang tunggu, ya. Santi and I waited in the waiting room. I was so distraught, so afraid, so sad. Tiba-tiba ada seorang perawat, orang hitam, saya masih ingat sekali. Dia masuk, dia kemudian tanya, saya bilang anak kami di dalam ruangan dokter lagi diperiksa terkena ini. Yes, he asked me what was going on, so I explained to him what happened. And then he just, you know what he did? He put his arm around me. And you know what happened to me? I hugged him and I cried like a baby. I just cried. I just broke down in tears. I could not hold myself together anymore. Saudara, malaikat Tuhan. He was an angel of God. He was an angel of God. Jadi Tuhan tahu. God knows. Yeah. He knows what we need. He knows what we need. Tuhan tahu apa yang kita butuhkan. Dan dia akan kirim malaikatnya, hambanya, anak-anaknya untuk berbisik kepada kita, I am with you wherever you go and I will never forsake you. Ya. Sambung lagi, let's continue. Tidak selalu kita berani, tapi setidaknya kita mesti berani untuk mengakui bahwa kita takut. Tambahkan kata takut. We're not always brave. No, we're not always brave. But at least we must be brave enough to admit that we are afraid. Saudara, jadi perlu keberanian untuk mengaku bahwa kita sedang takut. Itu kan penyakit kita manusia, ya. So it takes courage to admit that we are afraid. Kenapa kok kita gak mudah-mudah mengakui kita takut? Karena kita takut nanti dikatai orang kita takut. Ya, yeah, we don't want to tell people that we are afraid because we don't want people to think that we are afraid. Well, in fact, we are afraid. So, it takes courage to admit that we are afraid. Jadi inilah pelajaran ketiga yang dapat kita petik. Yakni, meskipun takut, kita harus berani. Tambahkan kata berani, mengakui bahwa kita takut. So here's the third lesson that we can glean. Even though we are afraid, we must be brave to admit that we are afraid. Jangan malu, akui dan katakan kepada Tuhan bahwa kita takut. Do not be embarrassed. Admit it and tell God, most of all, tell God that we are afraid. Saudara, seingat saya itu tuh rasanya, ya, seingat saya belum pernah berkata kepada Tuhan, Tuhan saya takut sampai saya mulai sakit. As far as I can remember, before I got sick, I had never said to God verbally or whispered to God that, Lord, I am afraid. I don't think so. Tapi waktu saya mulai sakit, masuk ke rumah sakit dan sebagainya, baru itu saya masih ingat, saya mulai berkata, Tuhan, saya takut. I remember, I think that was the first time when I began going to the hospital, receiving treatment, then I began telling God, literally, I am afraid. I am afraid. Nah, saudara, jadi juga jangan malu untuk mengakuinya di hadapan orang, bukannya anjing kita, ya, bukan. Orang. Yeah. So don't be embarrassed to admit it before somebody else. Yeah, some of us only want to admit it before our doggy. No, no. Admit it before somebody. Ada sesuatu yang biasanya terjadi tatkala kita mengakui dengan terbuka bahwa kita takut, yaitu ketakutan kita berkurang. tambahkan kata berkurang. Yeah, something happens when we openly admit that we are afraid. Somehow, our fear is now lessened, not as strong anymore. I wish I could tell you, you would have no more fear. At least that's not what happened to me. Maybe it would happen to you, but not to me. But at least, yeah, in my case, I really felt it. My fear was a lot less. When I just said to God, I'm afraid. Jadi inilah pelajaran keempat yang dapat kita timbak. Yaitu kita harus terus berjalan di dalam ketakutan. Tambahkan kata di dalam. Here's the fourth lesson that we can glean, we can draw, and that is, we must continue walking even in fear. Tuhan menyuruh Yosua untuk maju memimpin bangsa ini, dan Yosua taat, ia terus maju. You see, God tells Moses, and Moses, Joshua, to go on, to lead these people to the promised land, and Joshua obey God. He march on. Bila ia berhenti, maka ketakutan akan terus mencengkramnya. Dan ia akan terus, tambahkan kata terus, hidup di dalam ketakutan. You see, if Joshua decided not to go on and to just stop, what happened was fear would actually grip him. And he would forever live in fear. Puji Tuhan, Yosua tidak berhenti, ia terus berjalan. But thank God, Joshua does not stop, he walks on. Kita pun mesti terus berjalan di dalam ketakutan. We too must walk on in fear. Jangan tunggu sampai ketakutan hilang. Tambahkan kata hilang, baru berjalan. Do not wait till our fear is gone before we continue walking. Bila kita terus maju, setidaknya kita tahu bahwa kita pernah berhasil melewati situasi yang menakutkan itu. You see, if we walk on, then we will know we have at least gone through that experience and we survive.
Terus.
Ya, dan pengalaman ini akan memberi kita keberanian. Tambahkan kata keberanian. Untuk melawan ketakutan yang lain. And this will give us courage to face another fear. Jadi saudara, kalau kita mundur, kita bukan hanya nanti akan mempunyai satu ketakutan, tapi ketakutan itu akan beranak pinak. If we stop or retreat in the face of something that is fearful, we need to know this. That fear will not only stay, that fear will grow. So instead of only one fear, in the end, we will have two fears, three fears, four fears. Jadi, jalan terus. Meskipun takut, tidak tahu apa yang terjadi, jalan, ikuti perintah Tuhan. So this is what God tells Joshua to do. Even though you have the fear, walk on. Do not stop. Walk on. Not because you have no more fear. No, you walk on because you obey me. Even though you are walking in fear. Jadi ngerti ya, Tuhan gak mau kita tunggu sampai nanti gak ada lagi takut baru jalan. Enggak. Jalan meskipun takut. So that's what God wants us to do. Walk on. in fear. Do not wait until the fear is gone. Saya sudah selesai.